Here is a kind of classic work problem. The work needed to build a cone or a pyramid or some kind of prism. In this case, it's a cone. So it turns out that some researchers from Tel Aviv discovered an underwater monument in the Sea of Galilee that they believe may have been a Bronze Age burial site. Bronze Age, people started using metals, is 3000 BC. The cone-shaped structure is approximately 39 feet high and 230 feet across and weighs approximately 60,000 tons. Okay, and it's over here underneath the water. I can't really see it myself, but I see a bunch of stones there, so I believe it. Okay, so here's a cone, 39 feet tall. It's 230 feet across, so it's 115 radius. And here's a volume formula for a cone. So we're just verifying a few things here. This is how many cubic feet it is. And they say it weighed 60,000 tons. So how many pounds is that? 60,000 times 2,000 per ton. This amount of pounds. And I want to know what the stone density is so we can do our work problem. So the stone density is what we're after. So that's pounds per cubic foot. So we just divide those two numbers that we obtained there. And it's 222 pounds per cubic foot. That's a pretty heavy kind of stone. I looked that up, and peridotite happens to weigh that heavy. And it's found in the area, in the region over there in the Middle East. So maybe that's the kind of stones it was. Anyway, how much work did it take the people to build the cone? Well, first we're going to talk about the difference in the word weight between the metric system and the foot-pound system. This problem we're designing in the foot-pound system, but other problems that you'll be doing also have to do with the metric system. So anyway, force, which has to do with work, is mass times acceleration. In the metric system, the units of force are kilogram meters per second squared, because the kilogram is the mass, and the acceleration is, in our case, lifting something, pumping something out of something, is the force, the acceleration due to gravity in meters per second squared. So the weight of an object on Earth is its mass times 9.8 approximate meters per second squared, which is the acceleration due to gravity on Earth in the metric system. So when you say an object weighs 2 kilograms, 2 kilograms is just the mass part anywhere in space. On Earth, then you multiply it by the 9.8 to get the weight. So the force to lift it is F equals ma equals 2 kilograms times this number. So it would be 19.6 kilograms per meter. Kilogram meters per second squared, and they also call that newton. Kilogram meters per second squared, newtons. Okay, so that's force in the metric system. Now back to our problem. We're in the foot-pound system this time. Our gravity of 32 feet per second squared, good for on Earth, is figured into the pounds unit. It's inside of it. So if I weigh 200 pounds, then the force to lift me 200 pounds. Okay, so the weight is the force in that case. So now back to the cone. Work is the force needed to lift the object times the distance lifted. For our purposes, we're going to be lifting stuff straight up. So it's force times distance. Okay, so here's our cone. The strategy is to find out the weight of the stones on a slab cut up at a Y height. Okay, so slice that cone horizontally up at a Y height and see how much work it took to lift it from the ground up there to the Y height. And then all we have to do is add all those works up using our calculus, and we'll have the answer. So we need to know the volume of the cut up at the Y location. So what is this volume right there? Okay, so we need to draw this picture here. And realize that we need the radius across, that we need this, the radius, up at the Y height. Back on the picture, we need to know what this radius is across here. See, and so you have this nice right triangle picture here, over here, right? And so you have similar triangles there. And this is Y up to here. This happens to be 39. This is 39 minus the Y. So then coming down to this picture, this is what we have right here. 39 minus Y for that part. The A, I'm calling this A. This is a habit I have. So similar triangles, 39 minus A is to A as the big height is to the corresponding part, 115. So you work that all out, and A is equal to this. Another way you could have gotten that was to say it's a linear relationship. So when Y is 0, in other words, when you're on the ground, what is the A? It's all the way to 115, the full radius on the bottom. When Y gets to the top at 39 feet, what's the A across there? Nothing, 0, because you're at the tip. And then you get an equation, a linear equation, to fit those two points. And you get the same thing. Okay, so here's your slab cut picture. So the volume of the slab is this. Pi r squared height, the height of that slab. That's a cylinder now, not a cone. That cut is a cylinder. So it's pi r squared height, cubic feet. So what is the weight of the slab, to the force to lift it? Well, the density of stones was figured out to be 222 pounds per cubic foot. That'll be given to us in our problems. So the force to lift a slab is the density times the volume. And so you can see that cubic feet cancels out cubic feet and you get pounds. So the force in the foot pound system is the pounds. So that's how much it weighs. And then how far are you going to lift it? You're going to lift it from the ground up to the Y location. So that's Y. So the whole work on the slab to move it into the location is the force, which is the weight, which was obtained by the density times the volume times the distance you're going to lift it. And that all works out to be pounds times feet. It was the force times the distance, pounds times feet, but we call that foot pounds. The total work is a sum over all those cuts from Y equals 0 to 39. Then we have the total work equals the integral right over here. And I did a Simpsons calculation, you know, with the calculator, and got this amount of foot pounds. So that's the total work it took to build the cone. Now let's just go a little further. Assuming that a worker can do about 2,000 foot-pounds, because that's what our book says it can for some other problem we're going to do. They can do that much work per day, lifting the stones. and say they had 1,000 workers. Those workers could do 2 million foot-pounds of work per day, multiplying those two numbers together. So if you divide that into the total foot-pounds of work required to do it, and notice that's foot-pounds required over the 2 million was foot-pounds of work per day, so that all divides to days. And the foot-pounds cancel out and a day ends up in the numerator. So that all works out to 585 days, meaning that it would have taken 1,000 workers, if they had that many, working every day without holiday over 1.5 years to build the cone. So that gives you an idea of the massive effort that would take.